Yo, what's up? It's Kyle McMahon, and I am back with another Listen, React, Review, this time with Justin Timberlake's debut album, Justified. So I haven't heard it in a long time, and I'm going to be listening on Apple Music with Dolby Atmos. So I'm excited to hear it, not only for the first time in a while, but in a brand new way. So let's remember, before we jump into our Listen, React, Review, what was going on with the 2002 release of Justified? NSYNC had just wrapped up their celebrity tour in April of 2002, and they went on hiatus, which is then when Justin went into the studio to create Justified. He worked on the album half with the Neptunes, which of course is Pharrell and Chad Hugo, and half with Timbaland. And what he was looking to do was break himself away from that boy bander image and come into his own as an artist. Obviously, being a part of NSYNC, he was huge, and this was his big debut. This was his moment to show the world who Justin Timberlake was as an artist. The first single, Like I Love You, debuted in September of 2002 and gave us the first taste of what we could expect from Justin Timberlake. Many of the original tracks from Justified were originally for the Michael Jackson album, Invincible, and then were reworked with and for Justin for Justified. So let's jump right in to Justin Timberlake's Justified. First up, produced by the Neptunes and written by Justin and the Neptunes, it's Senorita. Those keys.
He's a friend of mine.
Yes, yes. Funky now coming in.
Justin.
Love that. Pharrell introducing Justin Timberlake to the world. Literally. And those drums are so the Neptunes.
Coming right here? Yeah. Come on.
On that sunny day, didn't know I'd meet such a beautiful girl walking down the street.
So soulful.
Coming down,
so he said to himself,
she deserves a crown, but where is it now? Mama, listen,
Senorita, I feel for you. You deal with things that you don't have to.
I hear these claps I never heard before. Tease the chorus there.
If we carry on this way, still deserve the crown. Why hasn't it been found? Mama, listen.
Senorita, I feel for you.
Feel for
those
you.
Horns.
Feel with things that you don't have to
love.
He doesn't love you.
Those runs. So funky, kind of new, but also classic. Here's the bridge. Those horns. Ooh, the background falsetto. So good. What a way to introduce.
With me.
Okay.
They go, it feels like something's heating up. Can I leave with you? Right. And then the ladies go, I don't know what I'm thinking about. Really leaving with you. Guys sing.
Okay.
It feels like something's heating up. Can I leave with you?
And ladies,
I don't know what I'm thinking about. Really leaving with you.
Feels good, don't it? Come on.
It feels like something's heating up.
Come on.
Can I leave
yeah.
with you?
Yeah.
Ladies, I don't know what I'm
sure
thinking
feel
about.
Good to me.
It's fun. This is an awesome introduction.
Wow, what a way to start. And it's to start an album and then introduce yourself to the world. What a great track. Senorita is a bop. Next up, we got...
Just something about you. The way I'm looking at you, what I keep looking at me. Getting scared now.
Those guitars.
Right? Don't feel me, baby. It's just Justin.
And those drums.
Right.
You can't just... You just can't not dance to this.
I kinda noticed something one night in your colorful face. It's kinda weird to me since you're so fine. If it's up to me, your face will change. If you smile,
that pre-chorus, oof, those vocals. Ain't nobody love you like I love you. Mm-mm-mm. You're a good girl, and that's what makes me trust you.
Hey.
So catchy. Like, this song, Like I Love You, is so catchy. It's such a great track. And this really was the first introduction to the world of Justin Timberlake as a solo artist and Justified as an album. It's so catchy. It's like slinky and subtle. There's this effect on his vocal here. Those keys in the back. Here we go. Remember Mace? No, this isn't Mace. I'm an idiot. Clipse. Clipse and Jade Timberlake, now how heavy is that? So slinky. Like, wow, what a banger. That was the Neptunes that produced that as well. Like, I love you.
No,
I love this part.
Dream about this when I was a little boy.
Like what?
I never thought it would end up this way. Drums. Hey. It's kind of special, right? Yeah.
So good. So good. So... Woo, that is a banger too. Like I Love You ended up hitting number 11 on the Hot 100, which I think is crazy that, you know, I think the song is so iconic and it was such a big part of me growing up. It didn't even hit top 10, which to me is insane, especially with Justin coming off of NSYNC, which was ginormous, and his debut single hit number 11. I mean, obviously still a huge hit and still a huge accomplishment. But, you know, in my life, it was number one. In interviews, Chad Hugo and Pharrell said that they had picked Justin up from the airport in Virginia and were listening to Earth, Wind & Fire songs. And that's partly what this was inspired by. Kind of like a new take on it. They also said that they listened to Off the Wall and Thriller by Michael Jackson on repeat, which helped not only with this song, but with all of Justified. Like I Love You is a certified bop. Let's keep going with track 3 on the album. Oh No, What You Got is first Timbaland song on the album, along with Scott Storch. There's Timba. Timbo. Timbaland is so amazing. Really leaning into R&B here. I love that. And that sample. Timbaland's vocals back in the back.
Oh no, girl.
I do love this breakdown coming right here. That's fire. There's all kinds of things going in. I love that. So, oh no, what you got? Good song. Not, you know, not the best on the album, but it's a, you know, good song that I wouldn't skip over. Next up on Justified, Take It From Here. So with Take It From Here, we go back to the Neptunes for production. Nice little slow jam with strings. It does have that kind of 70s Earth, Wind, and Fire vibe. So nice in here.
Don't you worry. I wanna be your lake or your bay. And any problems that you have, I wanna wash them away.
Oh, because he's gonna wash them away.
I wanna be your sky, so blue and high.
All right, Justin.
And every time you think of me, I wanna blow your mind.
Not the best lyrics in this one. Also, I never noticed that wind sound effect before. Love the guitar bass, too, which is, of course, a Neptunes thing. So much that you hear with Dolby Atmos that you don't normally. Of those dual vocals there. I love breakdowns in songs. That bass. A little bit corny with this breathy Justin Timberlake porn voice in my ear right now. It's a long track, too. Take It From Here. It's a good one. I like, you know, it's another one that I wouldn't skip. First kind of slower jam on the album. I like it a lot. Not love, love, love. I love the strings in it. I love the production, of course. The lyrics. Ooh, a little cringy. Next up, we all know this one, Timbaland and Scott Storch produced Cry Me a River, which, as we know, is thought to, if not, I mean, it's pretty much confirmed that Cry Me a River is about Justin's relationship with Britney Spears and the breakup, and apparently she cheated, but her book says that he cheated, who knows? But in any event, Cry Me a River, this is such one of the, in my opinion, best pop songs ever. Like those keys, the rain noises. And then two catchy key parts. And the vocal in the back.
my sun, you were my earth. You didn't know all the ways I love you, no. So you took a
chance, vocal mouth things in the background. I took up this pre-chorus is like, this chorus. That's bye-bye. I don't know what that is. I mean, it's in there. One thing that in this Dolby Atmos mix, those things by, I think they're Timbaland, that making those like kind of vocal, like, I feel like there's a Timbaland on each side of my ear, like making those noises in my ears, in my brain, and it's now it's a little bit distracting, which I've never noticed before. It's probably the Dolby mix, but it's like somebody's going. Like, it's so petty, but not petty. Bridge. This bridge is so good. Every part of this song is so good. Like this, just, oh my God, this song is so good. So good. And bringing his vocals back by themselves is by bringing the. So good. I mean, what can you say about Cry Me a River besides it is a certified bop? It is, in my opinion, one of the greatest pop songs of all time. Every part of it is catchy, every single part of it. The lyrics are great. There's multiple keyboard-based loops going on, synth loops. The background vocals, the production is just incredible. The vocals are amazing. And who can't relate to, like, you know, a lover where you're just like, you know what? Cry me a river. Like, you know, you mistreated me or cheated or whatever it is that you did. Cry me a river. I don't want to hear about it now. Stop posting on Instagram, okay, about it. That wasn't a personal analogy. Cry Me a River hit number 3 on the Billboard Hot 100, which again, like, I feel that song should have been number 1 forever. But anyway, let's go to Rock Your Body, which in my opinion, Rock Your Body is the most Michael Jackson-y song on Justified. We go back to the Neptunes for this one on production. This one was actually supposed to be on Michael Jackson's Invincible album, but MJ rejected the song, which, you know, this is an MJ song by Justin Timberlake, essentially. It's got some disco. It's such a great dancey track. Rock Your Body peaked at number 5 on the Billboard Hot 100, and it's a great song. Like, this is just, it such a Michael Jackson-y song. Ooh, I love in the... It's catchy immediately. It's got a funky dance groove, soul, disco. And that groove. And this like call out. Ooh, random girl. But it's good because when you're dancing, you know, the girls on the floor are like. So good. I love that back and forth. Dance break. Little beatbox, beatbox action by JT here. Ooh, that sounds good in Dolby Atmos. Breaking it down. Justin with his porn breath voice. All right. Rock Your Body. I love that song. That's another certified bop. Again, you know, I feel like these singles didn't do nearly as well as they really should have. There was a lot going on at that time in the pop world, a lot of great stuff. But looking back, I feel like some of these are very iconic songs in pop. Next up, the album track Nothin Else with the Neptunes as well. Slinky, kind of stalky, drivey. I love this. I guess she's... She works at a store. This is a good one. Again, the production is just flawless. Takes a diversion there. You're not green? Come on, Justin. You're out of this world, except you're not green. And back into that. I love that. Love these layered. No, please not green thing. Ugh. Cringy. There's his breathy porn voice again. They're right back into it. Ooh. Now kind of just vamping. Ooh, no. All right, Nothin Else. So I do love this one. The chorus goes in kind of an unexpected place from, you know, the verses, which I think is interesting. It kind of really deviates. Again, though, you know, it's another song with some cringy lyrics. You're out of this world, except you're not green. Like, no. No, 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 no. 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 No, 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 no. Good song, though. And as always, the production is top-notch, but that's what you get with the Neptunes. Next up, the Neptunes again on production with Last Night. I love that. Kind of classic Neptunes-y there. Layered, doubled vocals or tripled. Nah. Definitely Michael Jackson vocal tick there. It's interesting, the background vocal has more lyrics than the lead, and then they combine right there. It's nice. I like how so many of these songs, that, you know, you get the live band feel because, you know, they kind of play out like a band would. Love it. I really like Last Night. That's a good one. All right, next up is Still in My Brain, which is produced by The Underdogs, who one half of The Underdogs make up Kim Kardashian's ex-husband, first ex-husband. All right, so let's go into Last Night. I mean, Still in My Brain. I'm dumb. Nice.
Beautiful days are long gone.
Very much got that 60s, 70s soul.
Hasn't been that long since you walked away from me. Now I can try to act real strong. You and I both know I still think of you that way. You should know that beautiful lights.
I love that.
And I could say,
love that.
I've closed the door for our love. And I can tell you I feel still on my brain. Now,
real nice slinky R&B jam. Love those.
Even though I try to hide my broken heart inside, girl, you know me inside out, and I can't get you off of my mind.
All right, my Mantis came off with that. And that falsetto, this is great. This is like getting you in bed sort of R&B song. I love it. And the la-las. Another good one. This is, I think, my favorite slow jam on Still in My Brain. It's very R&B, but it's poppy, it's got that old school feel, but it's current even today. I love Still in My Brain, actually a lot more than I remember from when the album came out. All right, next up, and she said Take Me Now, which has a feature by Janet Jackson. This one is also produced by Timbaland and Scott Storch. And Janet's uncredited on this, I believe. It's a little bit dated. Cool. I like he goes lower with the lead there.
Take me now, hungry for your love.
There's Timbo. Claps. Gotta dance. Ooh. Ooh, so much going on in Dolby Atmos. Ooh, there, you gotta listen to this in Dolby Atmos. Timbo's got his own thing going on here. Feel like this is kind of what we'll eventually see in the next album, Future Sex Love Songs Sounds, where songs end up deviating into completely different songs, but as part of the same song, if that makes sense. This just goes on for like a full minute. All right, I like that one. At first, it sounded dated, and then once the full production kicked in, it redeemed itself. Another strong one, could have been cut by a minute. You know, I love the idea of diverting to kind of a whole new thing in the middle of the song, which is expertly done in Future Sex Love Sounds. But that went on too long with Nothing Else Happening, so it is what it is. Good song. Next up, Right For Me, Timbaland and Scott Storch. This one has a feature by Bubba Sparks, which you may or may not remember from his song Ugly back in like 2001 or something, and he was produced by Timbaland too. I like the hand claps. Like the groove. Okay, a little bit of repetitive. I like that. So much going on in the back, musically. Flute? Bubba Gump. I mean, Sparks. Kind of uninspired on his verse here. Another one that goes on. This goes on for another 30 seconds. Another one that kind of meanders. But I like how they are experimenting with that, which, again, ends up being expertly done in the next album. This song, you know, it's all right. It's not my favorite. Kind of forgettable, to be honest. I'd forgotten it existed. So it is what it is. Next up, back with the Neptunes for Let's Take a Ride. I really like this one. Justin, you are not Spanish. Just stop with that. I love this groove, though. I'll explain, just grab your coat, girl. I love that. Again, lyrics, a little bit cringy. Mm. I feel like it's a good place for a band. Like, come on, everybody, sing. Stand up, I can't hear you. Bridge. I love that. Bringing that back from the beginning. I love that one. I really do love Let's Take a Ride. Cringy lyrics sometimes, but a great song overall. And finally, the album closer, Never Again, which was written by Justin and Brian McKnight, who, of course, was a big R&B singer-songwriter. Brian also produced this. It was obvious that Justin was trying to, really bring in true R&B artists, you know, from the producers to the co-writers. And he was trying to make his world in R&B, which I think he did a great job of. We'll get into my final thoughts in a moment, but let's take a listen to the album closer, Never Again. Love that. That the piano and the strings.
Would have given up my life for you. And I believed you because I loved you more than life.
This is beautiful.
And all you had to do was apologize. You didn't say you're sorry. I don't understand. You don't care that you hurt me. And now I'm half the man that I used to be. When it was you and me, you didn't love me enough. My heart may never mend, and you'll never get to love me again.
Beautiful. Ooh, and then that guitar comes in. Really beautiful here.
I don't understand.
Break it down.
You don't care that you hurt me. And now I'm half the man that I used to be. When it was you and me, you didn't love me enough. My heart may never mend, and you'll never get to love me.
Beautiful. This is an amazing album closer. It's an amazing song. Oh, no. Thought was going to hit that last note. That is a beautiful song, an amazing album closer. Brian McKnight's DNA is all over it. With the, you know, the picked guitar and the strings, just incredible. I love, 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 love that song. So let's look at Justified as a whole, okay? Really, really, really great album overall. Really strong debut. There are moments of absolute pure iconicness, I would say, in pop with, like, I Love You, Cry Me a River, Rock Your Body, Senorita. You know, really great, great strong songs that anybody would die to have in their repertoire. The fact that they're all on a debut album is even more incredible and speaks to the talent of Justin Timberlake, as well as the people that he chose to surround himself with, his producers and co-writers and all of that. It's also, it is very, very, very much an R&B album. It's not, you know, there are obviously pop elements to it. And, you know, it is a pop album as well. But it, at its heart, it is an R&B album. It is very, very, very much R&B, leans into R&B heavily, even on the poppy, dancey singles. You know, it's heavily influenced by R&B. I think that this is an amazing album. I really do. Now, do I think it is as amazing as what's to come next with Justin? No, Future Sex, Love Sounds is one of my favorite albums ever. From front to back, there's not a skip. There are a few that, you know, I'd probably skip here. There are, you know, I haven't listened to most of it in a while except for the singles. So that kind of tells you, you know, how I feel about it all this time later. Again, having said that, that doesn't mean it's bad. I mean, I love it. It's an amazing album. You got to listen to it in Dolby Atmos. Atmos, it gives you a whole nother way to hear it. There's things that I don't even know if I heard originally when they came out. There's things I definitely know that I didn't hear when the album came out. So let me know what you think. What do you think about Justified? What do you think about Justin's debut album? What do you think about what I think about it? Let me know. Subscribe, comment below, and let me know. Do you disagree? Do you agree? What songs do you agree with me on? What songs do you disagree with me on? I want to know, and we'll be doing Justin's discography very, very soon as we work up to the release of his brand new album. I also have more Madonna coming and more Taylor Swift. So make sure if you have not watched them, check out them and wherever the suggested videos may be and let me know what you think of those. More Listen, React, Reviews to come. I love ya. See you next time. We out.